Alright, boys and girls, here we go. Boom. Hello. Hello, welcome to Accidental Origin, a weekly writing web show. My name is Brendan, this is my show. What's going on, guys? What's going on? Exciting news. I have changed my camera setups a little bit here. So, yeah. You're going to see some differences with the way that all this is set up. It's a little fuzzy right now. Let's see if I can... The volume's super low. That's really odd. Let me take a look at it real quick. Using my Yeti. Let me. How's it now? Is it better now? Is it worse? Is my mic being completely ridiculous? Like, what's going on? Should be, how about now? How's it sounding now? Better or worse? Man, these headphones are literally falling apart. I'm gonna have to retire these bad boys soon. They're getting a little much. No change. Alright, how's it now? I don't know what's changed. I'm trying to figure it out. Welcome to Twitch, where the start of every show, or the scene of every game, any game, involves redoing every setting ever. I think that thing is awesome. My brother gave it to me for Christmas. It's like a... I'm looking kind of blue. It's weird. Yeah, well, I know it's going to be kind of blurry because this screen should be not so blurry. It is kind of blue still, though. It's definitely blue. The white balance is just off. Let the door open. Let's go with that. That's better. We're gonna go with that. Happy with that. My lights are also might be a little too bright at the moment. It's fine. It's all working. That's what's important. Anyway, so I changed my camera setup because I wanted to be able to do this. Check this out. This is my new micro desk. I just got it this week. It's like this cool plastic thing. It's designed to go between your keyboard and your monitor. So that you don't have to like look straight down all the time. But it's perfect for doing editing and like all that kind of stuff. I threw down this, these are the thumbnails from last week's Fear the Siren issue. So you can totally see them on here. And so I'm going to be using this a lot more during the stream. So you can kind of see what's going on, what I'm doing. Throw this aside for now. So, got all that stuff out of the way. So, what are we going to be doing today? Today, we are going to be working on a weird experiment I came up with last night while watching a Warhammer 40k tournament with Sam online. So, what we're going to be doing today is... this weird Games Workshop-inspired world-building exercise. So, when I was watching the game last night, they made a lot of changes to the 40k rules in the recent years, recent additions, that allowed you to create a lot of different types of teams. So you weren't like sort of stuck in just a single faction in the same way. Turn that down for a bit. So you create these different types of teams that were more mixes of the different factions, so you weren't stuck in the sort of very, very rigid roles of what people could do. The benefit to this is that you can make these really weird sort of teams in terms of the lore, in terms of the narrative aspects of the game. And I was sitting there thinking, oh man, like, there's all these crazy teams, we should do these things. And I kind of came up with this weird exercise where what we would do is we would take a list of factions from Warhammer. And I'm going to break this down a little bit in a second. And sort of mix them up and toss them together randomly and see if we can create some world build, like, build this cool other world with mixes of these sort of tropes and ideas that come from Warhammer. I don't know if it'll work. I don't know if it'll be interesting, but we'll see. We'll see. It'll be a fun experiment. And that's what this week is kind of going to be about. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing a different experiment. I'm not entirely sure what it'll be yet, but it will be an experiment because I will be streaming tomorrow as well, for those who were not aware. What else? What else did I want to talk about? So this is the list here. I've created it. Me and Sam worked on this last night. So we got Warhammer 40k. We got the different... So these are the current armies as broken down by them. And I do have a window open, so I'll be able to pull up some images and sort of give people an idea of what these different groups look like. We got our old sort of older school style, like Space Marine chapters, Imperial Guard groups, stuff like that, Chaos Space Marines. We got our Warhammer Fantasy with the current groups, and then the old school, like much, much less concentrated groups. It's a big list. And we got The Hobbit and Lord of the Rings, which Games Workshop also makes a game version of, and I decided to throw in there just to give it a little bit more of a traditional flavor. So those are in there as well. That's the last page of the list. This is just like a one without the titles so that I could copy and paste it really easily. And that's the same as what I have on my desk here. I have a physical copy just for me. Same list that we got going on here. So yeah, that's what we're going to be doing today. So I found a generator that is designed for like making tournament teams, and I decided that this is the easiest way to do this. I couldn't find anything that was a little bit more specific to my need without having to code it myself, and I didn't really feel like doing that last night at like midnight. So we have this. But this does the job pretty well. The rules I'm going to stipulate for this are that this is going to give me groups of four. I'm going to choose three of the four to make my new fantasy race / team / culture, however you want to describe it. Fantasy, I'm not sure. It might be a little sci-fi. We'll see. We'll play with it. I might do both. Maybe I should try and specifically do both do a sci-fi version and a fantasy version and see if they'll be different or the same or whatnot, you know? Yeah, that's totally an option as well. But yeah, so it's going to give me groups of four off the list. Yeah, let's just see what happens. All right. So what do we got? So I should have 16 groups. Yeah. Paste these groups into my project file here. Oh, yeah, there we go. That's the easiest thing to read ever. Wow, okay. Remove color. Oh, it's because they're links, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. There we go. Let's make this actually readable on stream. That'd be good. Okay, I want this to be Warrior Prime. Why is it showing up as -1? That makes no sense. Don't even know. So strange. Weird. Super weird. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna have to do the old-fashioned way, I guess. This is taking longer than expected. I didn't realize I would have to cut and paste this like this. Yeah, there we go. We got 16 groups. And yeah. We're gonna go group one. Duplicate you. All right, cool. So we're good. Let's expand all these so we can see them. So this probably looks pretty weird in general, but this is the basic of world building, where, you know, we're expanding out from a concept. We're trying to build out of nothing, right? So let's see what we got. Why are you giant? So let's get some photos and stuff. What do I want? Let's go.
first and only.
Let's copy some stuff here. Give us some background info. Actually, what we're gonna do is we're gonna split this. Opening up like a billion windows, flipping around through stuff. Okay. Space Marines. But, where are the Adeptus Arbites, Sam? What section are they in? Are they not Space Marines? Found him. Okay, cool. I just didn't know. Yeah. Little known fact, Games Workshop is actually British. And so 2000 AD, which is also British and totally a thing. That's cool. Some Necrons. Basically walking skeletons with ziggurats. Split this. Are you trying to correct my pronunciation? Because you know it'll never work. This would be races. Oh no, this is from the new list, isn't it? That's why. Grand Alliance. Wait a second. Is that from The Hobbit? Oh, it is. It's a faction with literally one unit in it from The Hobbit. my bad. Oh, Arbites? Like Archimedes? Interesting. Didn't know it would do that, but cool. Doesn't matter. Does not matter. Images don't work very well in this. to define this group. So I'm going to pull out, I'm actually going to make this brainstorm. Make you brainstorm and you start here. Okay. So what are we going to do? Alright, so we got police force. Judge Dredd. Police force, Judge Dredd. We got Recon, light infantry, and last of their kind. We got living skeletons. Yeah. I mean, Gaunt is like such a living legend in that lore, right? Like he's all over the place all the time. And I'm just going to pull up some info. Oh, that's a neat story. Apparently Games Workshop created two miniatures of Peter Jackson as a hobbit from Bree. One is owned by Peter Jackson, the other is kept on display at GW headquarters in England. That's pretty funny. Got stone trolls. Some sort of Vagabonds, I guess.
I mean, probably. Apparently they did make a toy of it. I think, unless this is the Citadel Miniatures one that I'm thinking of. No, this is made by Toy Biz, so yeah, no, this is not the, I got it. Check this out, it's awesome. Great figure. So, we got our brainstorm here. So, what kind of culture do we want to create with this? Like, what are we trying to create? Well, the heavy metal team are the best. That is what they do. They're some sort of transient people. Yeah, I could see that. I think the Last of the Kind thing resonates pretty well with a lot of it as well. I kind of feel like I should cut out the Necrons. I find Necrons a little bit too distinctive. So I can cut out those two, probably. So we're looking at some sort of... Well, let's think about this bit. So we got trolls, we got vagabonds, we got our Judge Dredd cops. So, we're gonna say some sort of vehicle group, I guess. I think I'm going to define this setting as a post-apocalyptic fantasy setting. So, a setting that would be... It's got some science fiction elements, some Mad Max style elements, but also has things like magic and all that, where you kind of have a mix of the two. And technology is kind of free-roaming between stuff that survived and stuff that... from the past that has kind of been redone. So in this setting, I think what we're gonna have is, because that's the cool thing about Judge Dredd, right? Judge Dredd is all about the motorbikes. So we're gonna say biker gang. And we're gonna go, yeah, biker gang, they police at night, taking from your sort of stone trolls, nocturnal sort of style creatures. Thank you. think that's a pretty good description of who these people are. Just gotta name them. What should we name them? What should we name these people? Gonna make a quick note here. Move it up to there. Well, we're going to come back to naming them, I think. But first off, I am going to take a break. About that time. Oh, man. Yep. So break time. I will see you all in about 10 minutes. And we're going to keep going on this and just work our way through it. See if we can get all 16 done. See if we can use these ideas to create a sort of setting, a area where these other cultures exist. And maybe that'll be the basis for something else I do. But for now, we'll see how it goes. So yeah, I will see you all in 15 minutes. also sad that I have no popcorn. But I am back. So, yeah. I haven't figured out what I want to name these people yet. But I'm not going to get stuck on it. I'm going to move along. And work on the second group. Here. Because why not? The whole point is to be fast and loose with this. Not get bogged down too much in the details. I wish I had more info on what consists, what the flavor of the Hobbit factions really was. It's the Army of Lake Town. What do we got? We got let's put down some of these guys here. Army of Lake Town, that's about what we got here. Moria. Let's do Moria next. For the record, this is what I'm looking at.
That was odd.
We got all kinds of stuff in here. There's my armies from The Hobbit, and then we're gonna open up. let's go Chaos Space Marines. Space Marines. What was Slaves to Darkness? Chaos Space Marines. And Slaves to the Darkness. What list is that on? Grand Alliance Chaos.
just more chaos stuff. Alright, cool. I don't know anything about this faction.
could be interesting. We'll see. I'm going to skip that group for now, though. I don't like them all that much. That's one. Looking for order with horse. Martian man-eaters. Some betas. Serpentis.
Tomb Kings.
Which are over here.
Tomb King. Terax Guard. this is dwarves. What do they call that? I can never remember what the stupid thing is called.
think that these are mostly just high elves, basically. So that's one more group done. Welcome to the writer's life. Just tons of little organizational details. going to take another 10-minute break, and I will see you all shortly. Just trying to get a lot of the little bits out of the way so that I can get into the more creative work.
get all this stuff finished up.
Alright. Yeah, I'm only at group 6 of 16. Let's get this done. Thank you.
almost 3 o'clock. Which means we've been basically working on this for about 3 hours. Which always astounds me. How fast the time goes when you're streaming. Yeah. What do we think? Well, I didn't do as much of the creative fun side of this as I thought I was going to do today. Frankly, the craziness of the list, as Sam put it, is all over the place. But that's okay. You know, that's part of the process. And like I've said before on Accidental Origin, really, I want to show that process. I know it's not always the most entertaining thing, but I want to show you the process. I want to show you the failure. I want to show you the whole gambit of what the being creative is, what being a writer is. So I hope I'm communicating that in some sort of way. That being said, I am going to be streaming tomorrow. I said I would do that for February. Maybe March as well, but definitely for February. So I will be streaming tomorrow at 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, or whatever the current daylight savings is. Whatever. 12 p.m. my time, Eastern. So I will be back doing that. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the creative... the creative aspect of this. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time today finishing this out, getting it ready for tomorrow so that I can work on at least 5 or 6 of them tomorrow, put them down, see how it goes. If I'll also prepare a... I'm making a note for myself so I remember prep 5, 6. For tomorrow. I'm also going to prepare a second set of exercises completely unrelated to this. So that, you know what, if it's not as interesting as I want it to be, I can switch to something else. So, you know, you have that option, right? So, yeah. Yeah. I don't know. That's all I got. Do I have any news? I don't have any news yet. I will have news soonish. As far as things go. So yeah, today was okay. Today was okay so far. We will see how tomorrow goes. I'm excited. Yeah. Cool. So yeah, without further ado, my name is Brendan. And this is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. As always, you can check out the website just over there, accidentalorigin.com. Follow me on Twitter for news and announcements. Yeah, and the website has VODs. That way. The website has VODs and links to various articles and whatnot. Each episode. Yeah, sorry. Got lost in thought there for a sec. So yeah. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. Have a good one. I'll see you all